Hello, it's John here. This is going to be a new video series, and it's time I started looking after my collection. Now, I've got VICs, I've got 64s, got 128s, plus 4, C16. C16 wannabe, but yeah, that's got Windows 95 on it. I've got a couple of Amigas, got loads of BBCs, but I've got Model A's, lots of Model B's, issues 3, 4, 7. Amstrad CPCs now, Spectrums, all variety of Spectrums. I didn't realise how many Spectrums I've got. And so, with the experience of the getting the 128s refurbed by Matt has given me the idea of a refurbing of my own. Like I said at the end of the video, I ought to try it. Well, so I went and ordered sillily lots of stuff. Right, so what's come through is, hang on, let's see if it focuses on that. There you go. I've got some heat sinks already pre-thermal taped prepared, and I bought over 200 of them. Got a lot of computers, but what I'm going to do is on the chips, I'm not going to put one on, I'm going to put two on or three on if they do get hot, like the basic ROM on the C64 and the VIC gets very hot, and the PLAs do as well. So I bought over 200 of them. Isopropyl alcohol wipes, because spraying it on the machine and then wiping it off, I'm not convinced you're not going to do any damage. So I've got proper healthcare wipes, yeah, and which I'm going to clean the CPUs with before I put the heat sinks on. And finally, I bought one of those. Now, ignore the box because I've put everything in the box, but what they are is, I'll take a pack out so you can see. There you go. They are capacitors, electrolytic capacitors of various shapes and sizes. All 50 volts, because from what I've read, with a capacitor it's always got better to go higher than the voltage than lower. So I bought every flavor I could see in terms of microfarads. So these are 2200 microfarads, all 50 volts. So I've got them going from, you know, like there. They're 330. They're, what are those? Crikey, the writing's so small, I can hardly see it. What is that? 3.3 micro. So they're 3.3 microfarads. And I got a variety, because when I was looking on the VIC specs and the ZX Spectrum specs and all that, they all had different microfarad ratings from one VIC 20 to the next. You know, that, like the one I've got here is like a Mark IV. You know, my Play VIC, this is the one I'm going to be updating, the Play VIC. So I think it's Mark IV. I have got my Mark I, I've got a VC 20, so it's a German VIC, and I think they're Mark 3s. But they all have different, because they have different motherboards, they all have different capacitors that go in them. So I decided to buy a job lot, 50 volts of every capacitor that I could find. And luckily there was a seller that does a complete set of capacitors in all the different ratings, even the ones that I don't really need. But I thought, instead of buying individually, it costs less to buy them in bulk, buy loads of them. So I bought two sets. So I've got over 300 capacitors in that box. Anyway, so this is the start of what I'm going to call future-proofing my machines. So first up, I'm going to cut my teeth on this one. And the reason I'm going to cut my teeth on this one is I have got a spare motherboard, so if I screw it up, I'm fine. I should be okay. But I don't intend to screw it up. I'm getting pretty good with the soldering iron. And I'm going to replace all the capacitors in here with new ones. And before I'm going to take it apart, I'm going to put it on the TV so I can show you the main reason why I'm doing it, because the video looks rubbish. And then I'll put it when I've finished it, so I'll record doing it, put all the heat sinks on it, put that together, and then I'll plug it back into the TV. Hopefully it will switch back on, and then we will see if the video, if it's been worth it. I mean, it'll be worth it because I've put the heat sinks on the chip in that respect, because it means the chips will last longer. But hopefully with the new capacitors, the video signal should be a lot better. I mean, the fact that the ZX Spectrums were immeasurably better. So with that, I'm going to put this away over there. I'm going to get the set it up on the TV, and then we'll have a play, and then we'll go and take it apart. Yeah, he's saying it out loud now, making me a little bit anxious. You've seen what my soldering skills are like. I should be fine, hopefully. Anyway, I'll see you in a minute. Take care. Right then, I've plugged the VIC 20 into TV, because I want to show you what sort of picture quality I'm getting on my play VIC. So I'm just going to power it up now, so you'll see that it'll come up on the screen. There we go. So SCART, it's in PAL mode. And what I want to show you is that, can you see that speckle checkerboard effect and the shadowing on the border? Can you see where there's dotted lines on the white area, and the characters don't seem to be as crisp? You know, there's a little bit of bleeding going on. You know, it's and I think that is to do with the fact that the capacitors are so old that they may have dried out and we need to replace them. Right, so I just want to show you how bad that is. I'm gonna 3, 6, 8, 7, 9, 1. Right, so that's made everything. Oh, wow, that's a bit weird. Oh, I keep forgetting, don't I? Oh yeah, the background and the foreground. Polk 36879, 38. Oh, look at that. Anyway, that's a ideal situation that I wanted to show you, is the fact that the video gets all blocky when you try and do, you know, this sort of stuff with it. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to plug in my, where is it, the 16K module.
plug the extender board in. There we go. 16k module on it. Right, switcher on. So we should end up with. Nope. Do I turn it off? Put it on. Turn it on. There we go. That's 8K. So it's in 8K configuration. That's a bit.
I don't even know what 16K is on that. Oh, I've got a 16K switchable RAM pack and I don't know what it is. Let's try
that. What's that put it to? There we go.
Hitting like you. Right. FB. Right, let's do load that one. FB-8K, 9.
So, I think it's in there. Nope. Oh, where did I put it? Oh, there it is.
Right, so, well, this is taking a while. It is a big game. Right, can you see where it says press jump? You can hardly make out the M. Right. That's jump. Here. Yep. Okay, where's left and right? There we go. Panic minor for the Vic. What? Panic minor for the VIC 20. But as you can see, some of the graphics have got that shadowing, and I think that's down to the capacitors in the VIC system. So what I'm going to do now is we're going to go over to the soldering table and we're going to future proof this VIC. Right, I'll see you in a minute. Take care. Hello.
Right.
Taking the motherboard out of the VIC, and I've now got a grounding lead. I was told off last time when I was doing some soldering on motherboards. So here's the VIC 20 motherboard. It's looks like a Mark IV, I think. But the difference between this. Big difference between this one and my original Mark 1 is the Mark 1 has a massive heatsink here, where, you know, it because 9 volts is the only thing that comes in, it has a massive heatsink with a 5 volt regulator on the inside. But this one has the 5 volts coming in from the outside anyway, so we lost all that. So we're talking
So the capacitors that we're talking about, we've got a 2200 microfarad one there. We have a 100 microfarad one there. Sorry, 100 microfarad one here. Here, this one here is a 10 microfarad, that looks on it. And then we've got some ones inside here with the VIC chip. Let's get this focused. There we go. So some inside here with a VIC chip, and that looks like a I can't tell. Can't see really. So we're gonna desolder them all. Well, we're gonna desolder one at a time, so I know what I'm doing. And so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 electrolytic capacitors to replace. Yeah, this is gonna be fun. Right, let's get the soldering iron warmed up. I'll see you in a minute. Right then, so our soldering iron's warmed up, and the easiest one will be the one that we're going to do first. So I need a 22 microfarad capacitor, which I had one already when I was showing you guys an introduction. Let's open the bag. Yeah, 2200 microfarad. Now, as you can see, we're going to have to do a little bit of manipulation because this is side by side, as this is not. And we've got to make sure we've got the right sides on. So let's just make sure. So this is the negative side. Will it reach? Yeah, it'll reach. Right. So, and we'll have to lie it down, I suppose, so it doesn't get in the way of the down once we've done it. Right, let's take the first one out. So we're talking that point there and that point there. All right. Right, that looks like it's done it. Well, not quite. step one, getting the old capacitor off. Took longer than I thought. Right, so that's the old one. Let's get the new one. Right, negative goes into the negative end. Positive goes in the positive end. Lift off. Right then, we have two legs. Right. Hopefully that's not going to get too much in the way of the motherboard. The first one. How long did that take? Right, I'm going to fast forward the rest of it and we'll take it from there. We'll be right back. Right, that's all the capacitors done, and the electricians amongst yourselves will probably have been shouting at the monitor, John, what are you doing? John, what are you doing? The answer is, I don't know. So, here's the culprits that are replaced. There you go. So I replaced that one, which is a 2200. 100 microfarad is that one. Then here was a 10 microfarad. Yep, there. This one was a 47 microfarad. This one was a 10 microfarad. Oops. 10, yep. And this teeny tiny one here is a 1 microfarad one. So I've replaced all of them. So the next thing I need to do, still pretty warm that is one, clean all this crap up. Now we don't need these anymore. Right, is to put some heat sinks on them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put two on there to the one, the VIC chip. I'm going to put two on the 6502. I'm going to put one on each of the ROMs and that one there, and I'm going to put one on the CIA. So I'm going to put 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So I need 11. And I think each pack I've got has 12 in. Let's have a look. Two for the VIC, two for the bottom pair, two for the CIAs, one each, one in the middle. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11 with one spare. So I'm gonna clean the top of the. Wow. I'm not sure, you didn't want to get in there. Right, so I'm gonna clean the top of the chips off. With these swabs. So there's no dirt between them. Excellent. Look how much dirt come off the top of those chips. Look. Right, that's one, and we'll do a precautionary one just to make sure. Right, so that's prepared the chips. So it's just a case of putting these heat sinks on now. So wait for the alcohol to evaporate. It looks like the VIAs are done, so we'll put one each on each of those. This is where you need nails, everybody. This programmer has none.
Right.
So that's the first one. So we'll put the first one on there. Like so. Then we'll put the one on the next one. Right, I'm going to speed this up for you guys because this will be boring watching me putting sticky pads on. So I'm going to start with. I'll see you when I talk to you when I've done it all. Right, that's the heat sink's put back on. I've just noticed this big capacitor is wobbling and there's a dry joint here. Just waiting for the soldering iron to heat up. Get it to reflow.
That could be it.
Let's have a look. That's better. Right. So everything has got heat shields on it. And so now it's a case of powering it up. Just power it up as it is and just see if it works. Right, I'll see you in a minute. I'm just gonna plug the board into the telly, just gonna power it up. See you in a minute.
Bye.
Right then, so all I've done is just plug the motherboard into the power and the TV. So I'm just about to switch it on. Right, switch the power on to the power supply. There we go. And switch on. After all that, made no difference. At least she's working still, and she's been future-proofed. Oh, I thought the capacitors would sort all that out. Never mind. Right then, let's put her back in the box and let's see if she's truly working. I'll see you in a minute. So we've put it in the TV. And she's still working. Didn't make much of an improvement to the signal, to be honest. But she's future-proofed now. New capacitors and heat sinks. She should be fine for years to come. So I'm gonna install her back into her rightful place, give her a once over on the TV, and we'll call it a day for this one. Right, I'll speed through this because you guys don't want to see me screwing in screws, so I'm just going to quickly speed through it. I'll talk to you when I've done it. Right, there we go, snapped her into place. Yep. Right, one recapped and heat sinked VIC-20. Let's plug her in the machine and see if we've done any damage. I'll see in a s- plug her into the machine, why is he there? Plug her into the telly and see if we've done any damage. Right, I'll see you in a minute, take care. Right, I've plugged her up to the telly, plugged the 16K RAM card back in, and my SD to AC. Switched her on, and there we go. I suppose it's only a little bit better. Not a lot. But, right, it's FB-20. Wasn't it? -8K, -9. Manic Miner was in my games, wasn't it? Yeah, we go, Manic Miner. We've still got the tram lines. It was worth the try. Maybe the damage on the chips had been too much. Yeah, it's not a lot of difference. But she's still running with brand new capacitors. And I can't complain at that. Oh, I can play how rubbish I play this game. Oh, what? What? Really? Am I that bad? I've been thinking of starting a new series. John Tries to Play. If you think it's a good idea, put a comment in the comment and I'll consider it, because how do you get up there without hitting that? I don't remember it being this difficult. There we go. Go on, John. See if you can do screen one. Oh! I knew it as soon as I jumped. Right. Okay. Well, we haven't broken it. I should say, I haven't broken it. She's still working. She's now got some heat sinks to make sure she doesn't get too hot when I'm playing with her now. Pity about the screen, but never mind. It might settle down, I don't know. Okay, if you like this video, please click that like button. If you didn't like it, fine, hit that dislike button. Always leave a comment. And if you would be so kind and please become a patron of mine and support this channel, all the money that's taken goes back into doing this channel. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye. Hello, this is John, and this is a sort of an epilogue entry. Excuse me. I was putting the video together, and when I was looking at the screen capture of the VIC 20, I swore blind that the picture was a little better. So what I've done is captured two frames from both of the screen capture videos almost exactly at the same point during the Manic Miner game to see if there was a difference. So here it is. This is this capture of the Manic Miner introduction screen before I did the fixes, and as you can see, there's tram lines, the M looks like a little B, and stuff like that. So, and that's one of the reasons why I did this job. So if I go to the after, there is a difference, and quite a significant difference as well. See, the tram lines are not as obvious. The writing looks a bit more defined. So if I go back, forward, can you see the background, the blue background? That's a lot paler. This is a lot deeper in colour. The background is a lot deeper in colour. It's not as wishy-washy. And admittedly, the M still looks the same, but the interesting thing that I did notice was that when I was looking at the video for where is it? Let's why can't I make this smaller? There we go. Right, so if I there's the startup screen, and you can see this furriness there and stuff like that. It's quite pronounced. And then when you go to the where are we? There. It's not so pronounced. So just by comparing these two screenshots together, a stupid thing, there we go, we have, so that's the after, that's the before, we have, and what I'm going to do is while I'm talking now, I'll put them side by side on the screen. The capacitor change did make a difference on the video. It's made the video colours far more not so wishy-washy out. It's the far, oh, what's the word? Rich. The colours are far richer than they were before I did the capacitor update. So I just thought I'd let you know that I was convinced there was a picture difference, and so I needed to do a side-by-side comparison, which is what you can see now. And it's based around the colours, not based around the pixels, but around the colours. So, all right then. So I will say ta-ta for now,
And if you liked it, please click that like button. If you didn't, right, hit the dislike. Oh, my phone's gone off. And if so wish, become a patron of this channel and help drive forward the channel. Right, I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye. I'd like to thank all the patrons that are contributing to my channel. Without you guys, I wouldn't be able to do what I'm doing right now. Thank you very much.